Hello everyone, welcome back to Act of Learning. Ever since the 3 blue 1 brown video on derivatives through geometry, there has been many videos and posts discussing the derivative of the function 1 by x. The general approach considers a rectangle of unit area with one corner on the origin and the other on the hyperbola 1 by x and analyzing how the area changes when the x coordinate is given a little nudge. This approach is perfectly fine, and it is this idea of infinitesimals that led to the derivatives of many other functions. But is this really a geometrical proof? Can we get the derivative of 1 by x without resorting to the idea of infinitesimals? What we have here is a hyperbola, one of the conic sections. The function 1 by x is not just any hyperbola, it is a rectangular hyperbola, which means its asymptotes, in this case, the coordinate axes, are perpendicular to each other. And finding the derivative of 1 by x in pure geometric terms is practically the same problem as finding the slope of the tangent at any given point on the hyperbola. It is known since the time of Apollonius that the tangential segment of a hyperbola caught between the asymptotes is bisected at the point of tangency. We'll see why this is true in a moment, but for now, let's stay on course. Given this proposition, we can draw a circle with the tangency point as the center and the segment as its diameter. By the converse of the Thales theorem, we know that the origin must lie on this circle. Labeling some of the points, we see that OP must be equal to PA because they are both radius to the same circle. The angle opposite these sides in triangle OPA must then be equal. The slope of the segment PA, which is the slope of the tangent itself, is its rise over run. By the geometry of the triangle, it rises by 1 by x for a run of negative x units, which tells us that the slope of the tangent is minus 1 by x square and is therefore the derivative of the function 1 by x. No infinitesimals, just plain old geometry. But we may be wondering how Apollonius knew the tangent segment is bisected at the tangency point. Because he was writing a general treatise on all conics, he proves this through a series of propositions to arrive at this result. But we confine ourselves only to the hyperbola, and let's see how we can prove this more directly. To prove the result about the tangent segment, we consider the rectangular hyperbola x square minus y square equal to 1 with x is equal to y and x is equal to minus y as its asymptotes. In fact, we prove an even general result. For any line cutting the hyperbola, we'll show that the midpoint of the segment caught between the asymptotes coincides with the midpoint of the chord created by that line on the hyperbola. The key idea of this proof is to make use of the third dimension as well. We know that the hyperbola is a conic section, an intersection of a cone and a plane parallel to its axis. In the third dimension, we extend the line that cuts the hyperbola to be a plane that cuts the cone as well. But we know that a plane cutting the cone gives us another famous conic, the ellipse. With this third dimension, we can clearly see that the segment caught between the asymptotes is just the major axis of the ellipse, and the segment caught between the hyperbola is a chord on the ellipse parallel to the major axis. Because of the ellipse's symmetry, the midpoint of both these segments must lie on the minor axis of the ellipse. But looking through the plane containing the hyperbola, the minor axis just appears as a single point which contains both the midpoints, showing that the midpoints of the segments coincide with each other. It really is that simple. back to two dimensions. This fact is true for any line cutting the hyperbola. In the limiting case of the tangent line, the curve and the hyperbola collapses to the tangency point, which then becomes the midpoint of the segment between the asymptotes. As an added bonus, we can use this to prove some more results about the hyperbola. For example, we can show that the area of the triangle created by the tangent and the coordinate axis is constant. Further, the angle between the radial line at a given point and the tangent line at a symmetric point are perpendicular to each other. Also, their point of intersection is the inverse of the radial point with respect to a circle centered at the origin and tangent to the hyperbola. All this with simple geometry. Hope you enjoyed the discussion. Thank you for joining me, and see you in the next video.